Hey guys, welcome back to another video. If you didn't watch the last one, it was a double DNF within the team. I got hit, the car was just too damaged for us to finish the race in. It's okay, hopefully we can do better this in Austria. It is a sprint weekend, so yeah. Let's just take some new engine. Yeah, let's go to damn it. There we go. The sprint seems a bit wet. Oh, the whole race seems, this whole weekend seems a bit wet. Let's go straight into qualifying. Yeah, we DNF'd last race. He's not wet qualifying. Let's hope we do good this race, because like, we need the points for money, we need the extra money. We're now fucking last, for fuck's sake!
And with qualifying complete, to P21, our top three today: Leclerc, Verstappen, and Carlos Sainz.
Seems like our car is shit, but his is faster. How's that fair? But we do personally have a new engine for both the sprint and this race. So yeah. But I don't want to do two pit stops, I just wanted to do one. What? Huh? What? Whatever. Why? Oh dear. Do you want to unlock now? Oh. Let's forget about this.
Running through the driver grid order for today's exciting sprint.
Ren's at the end, so yeah, we should be fine.
Oh.
5 red lights, and away we go for the sprint race at Austria.
Fine, let's try and move forward.
But we kind of need these points, they're important points. To help the team, basically.
The underbody's taken a little damage, just watch out for it.
Even, I don't care if we get P8, but I do. Yes, no legal overtake. So yeah. This video may be a two-parter because how long the races are. One's a sprint race and the other's not. So yeah. So I hope you are enjoying these videos. Yeah, Silverstone was a horrendous race for us. We went from P8 to P6 to P22. Basically, like.
DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Okay, we think the underbody's incurred some slight damage, but nothing too serious at the moment.
Let's try
just
getting this gap close
the
to
still looking good.
We'll be getting the RS this lap, we'll be getting it from the next lap we're now close to.
Okay, the underbody's taken some damage, you might start to notice it soon.
Yeah, let's try getting like at least a top 10 finish. Which indeed would be nice. For the team overall anyway.
Gap to your teammate behind is 4.8 seconds.
That's even if we can keep up to Ricardo.
To worry about the tyre condition for now, everything's looking good. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 1.7 seconds.
No, this is fun, isn't it?
You have damage to the rear diffuser. Repeat, damage to the rear diffuser. Just be aware. No threat of rain for the time being. Conditions look good. Dryers definitely seem like the fastest tyre at the moment.
So yeah. Are you fucking serious?
No rain expected. No rain expected for the time being. Okay, dryers seem like the best tire for now. Okay, no issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Okay, be very careful. The floor's incurred massive damage.
Probably are better with just the tyre in the car.
No tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Okay, watch your pace. We've been informed the safety car is out. There appears to have been an issue with multiple stopped vehicles on the track. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Watch that rear wing, you've taken some slight damage. Understood, copy that. Wow, that was a heck of an impact.
The car was fucked anyway. It's not even my fault anyways, the car was damaged badly anyway.
Let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. Our championship leader is still sat at the top of the standings, but their rivals have made up some solid ground today.
Mark Webber should share this game then. Let's do this.
Good afternoon and welcome to Spielberg, and to a circuit that in one form or the other has held every Austrian Grand Prix in the championship except the very first back in 1964. It was at this race that John Watson lost a bet and his beard when he took Team Penske's only F1 victory in 1976. If anything, the stakes are even higher today, with 25 points available for victory and a crucial advantage in the championship fight. It's one of the shortest laps on the calendar today then, with 7 rights and just 3 lefts making up the 10 corners of this high-speed circuit. Turn 2 is barely a corner at all. They'll be flat out through there.
We're just going to skip all this. Discuss.
Okay, here we go.
That was an okay start. Yeah, so hopefully the video that was going to be much better for us.
Tire condition still looking good.
Webber's like following every pace I go through.
8 DRS is now available.
Then two overtakes was easy because it seemed like Alonso had hit the back of them bus, but I don't think he did.
Okay, you're in the top 10.
Oh, right, then two are fighting. And we're ahead. So we're on the spot where you wanted to be in, like, in the sprint race, which failed. But yeah.
The gap to the car in front is 3.0 seconds. They're in 13th place, and the gap is 5.4 seconds. And the time last lap was a 1 minute 09.8.
Yeah. Now we're trying to close the gap on Norris.
No need to worry about the tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good.
Yeah, hopefully we do get, this is going to be a 10th one, but we can hope.
Conditions look stable at the moment, no rain currently expected. Dries definitely seem like the fastest tyre at the moment.
He doesn't even seem like composing this gap to Lando. This has been such a great race for us, man. Hang on, sorry guys.
You're losing a small amount of time to the car behind. Just keep pushing. Okay, radar is clear, weather is looking good for now. Okay, dry seem like the best tyre for now.
Maybe I'll cook this gap 10 times something faster if I make it making fucking constant fucking mistakes.
Okay, you've taken damage to the side pods. Expect to feel that look bad. Are you alright? Let me know you're okay.
For God's sake. Well, again, this has to be the end of this video. Because, again, We've lost. Oh my god!
Oh. The Mercedes team pulled out a fantastic performance today. They should be proud. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the... So let's have a look then at the driver's standings. Max Verstappen should be pleased with his performance, making gains at the top of the table. After an incredible day of racing, who is your driver of the day, Ant?
Daniel Ricciardo would be my driver of the day. He just outright refused to make any mistakes. Perfect driving.
Let's move on to the constructors. It was also a strong Grand Prix from Haas F1 this weekend. Fantastic work from the American team to move themselves further up the table. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.